me of two people, one of the singers was Phoebe and the Chosen Ones, that everybody saw me when I failed, but nobody saw me when I got up.
Oh, bless God.
Yeah, ain't that something?
Yeah.
And then it was a commercial when most of us was kids about the lady that said, I fell down, but I couldn't get up.
Yeah.
How many people know as long as we got Jesus,
all right,
we gonna get up?
All right.
Donnie McClurkin say that a saint was no more than a sinner that got up. I want to give everybody honor and their respectful place this morning. I want to give honor to God, our Creator. I want to give honor to Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. And I want to give honor to the persons of the Holy Spirit. Mm-hmm. Before we go into today's message, I want you to bow your heads and pray with me. Father, we come before your throne once again.
Yes,
Father God, not to do my will, not to have my way, not to be seen there, Father God, but just to do what you told me to do. Father God, I ask you to let me decrease and let your Holy Spirit increase. But Father, I ask you to have mercy on me. Father God, let your people hear me and also be doers of what they hear. Father, we pray this and we ask this. In your Son Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Back to Proverbs, starting at verse number 28. And it reads and it says, then shall they call upon me, but I will not answer. They shall seek me early, but they shall not find me. For he that hateth knowledge and did not choose the fear of the Lord. For they were none of my counsels, they despise all of my reproof. Therefore they eat the fruit of their own way and be filled with their own devices. For the turning away of the simple shall slay them, and the prosperity of the fools shall destroy them. But whosoever hearkeneth unto me shall dwell safely and shall be quiet from the fear of evil.
Yes.
I want to back up to verse number 29, and the title of today's message would be the fear of the Lord.
Uh-huh.
And why the fear of the Lord for this youth day, for this youth Sunday? I don't know about anybody else, but I'm an observer. When I watch television or watch my kids or my nieces or my nephews watching television, I observe the things that they're watching on television. And my brothers and sisters, I happen to know we're in a jacked up society.
Amen.
Where everything is going wrong, except everything is going the way God did not want it to go. My brothers and sisters, it looks like it's become a fad now for two young little girls to be together and two young little boys to be together. But this is no broken record. This is just to examine what's going wrong.
Amen.
And we have to talk to our youth. Mm-hmm. Right now, social media has our youth confused.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Come on, preacher.
Because everything that they're doing, and they still say they're Christians. Mm-hmm. Right. Now, I'm not judging because I love youth. Mm-hmm. And I'm not pointing the finger at one youth because there are some youth that's in my family that's jacked up too.
All right.
Amen.
But I want to be one of the people that help because I love the youth. Mm-hmm. I want to be one of the people that help give good instructions.
Amen.
And to all the youth, I want to let you know you're going to get a grace card this morning. It's not your fault.
All right.
Now let me hear all the children say, I need some more evidence.
Damn.
I'm preaching to y'all. I need some more evidence. All the time, y'all hear all the grown people say, what you do wrong, it's your fault. Don't y'all need some scriptures for that?
Yeah.
Y'all might want to say, preach, brother man.
Preach, brother man.
All right. I need some participators. In Genesis chapter 4, verse 7, it says, to Cain, if thou do well, you will be accepted. But if you don't do well, it says that sin lies at your door. Its desire is for you to rule over you. Genesis 9 and 21. So this ain't something I'm just saying. This is something that God put into my spirit to help the youth.
Right.
I don't want to be one of the people that talk about the youth, talk about the short dresses, talk about their tops out, talk about the dirty dances that they're doing on social media. I want to be one of the people that help and talk to them. And this is what real love is about.
Right.
It says, and the Lord smelled a sweet savior. And the Lord said in his heart, I will not again curse the ground anymore for man's sake. For the imagination of man's heart is evil from his youth. Neither will I again smite anymore anything, any living thing as I have done. So what is that saying? This is more than 42 generations ago. The Bible is more than 2,000 years ago. And here is God destroyed the earth because of a lot of bad things that came out of people from their youth.
Yeah. Yes,
and we must address that because too many youth are getting locked up.
Amen.
Too many youth have drive-by shootings.
Amen. Yes, sir.
And we say we love each other. See, love is a very powerful, powerful word.
Yeah.
Because when you say, I love somebody, let me show you how love, how deep love is. There's a thing on television where this man said, if I can't have you, nobody else could. Whoa. That was love. That person was going to get killed.
Yeah.
That's I don't want that kind of love.
Yeah, all right.
Criminal minds show you all kind of crazy people,
yes, sir,
that love people in mysterious ways.
Uh-huh.
I'm talking about love, when you really say that you love each other. In Matthew 15:9, it says, for out of the heart proceeds evil thoughts, murders, adulteries, fornication, theft, false witness, and blasphemies. I got a question. Where do watermelon come from?
A seed.
Come from the seed, right? Plant the seed, the watermelon grow. Anybody ever teach the watermelon how to grow? The watermelon already know how to grow. Right? A seed make a watermelon, right? And a watermelon grow like a watermelon, right? Same thing with an apple, or same thing with an orange, right?
Right.
So I got a question. Where do loosellers come from? They come from big sellers.
Yeah.
See, a lot of times, children, what our parent won't tell you is, sometimes we're trying to protect y'all from being just like us.
Amen.
They say that the fruit don't fall from the what?
Tree.
All right. Sometimes parents are on edge because they knew how they were.
Yes.
And they're not telling you to do these things because they don't want you to have fun. Mm-hmm. They're not telling you to do these things because they don't want you to live your life. But I think in some cases, and I think in a lot of cases, parents, we ought to give our children a break because some of this stuff comes from our genes. Because some of this stuff, it comes from the genes.
Yeah.
And if you don't believe me, how many people install where a mother would look at the son and say, you act just like your daddy.
Yeah.
And then some of them say, we act just like your mom.
Yeah.
You look just like your dad. You talk just like your dad. You walk just like your dad. Why? Did that kid choose that?
No.
It was passed on.
Right.
Some of us children curse because our parents curse.
All right.
Some of us children might even have a desire to drink because we saw our parents drink.
Mm-hmm.
It don't make it right.
Come on.
But we must do the right thing.
Yeah.
So in order for our children to live a holy life,
mm-hmm.
In order for our children to want to be in church,
mm-hmm.
In order for our children to want to worship God up and give God the glory, give God the honor, the truth must be in us.
Amen.
See, sometimes, children, we become political because we give the highest praise in church, and then we give the most gossip behind closed doors.
Mm-hmm.
It can't be that way. Where does evil come from? It comes from the youth. David said in the 51st division of Psalm, verse 5, he said, I was born, I was shapen in iniquity, and in sin, my mother conceived me. How many people know that Adam got us all messed up. Because of Adam, we was all born in sin. All right, how many sins do we have on earth? Can't name them. But all unrighteousness is sin. So children, we're speaking this morning trying to help y'all in bad situations. Things go on in school that shouldn't go on in school.
Amen.
There was a time that when we was growing up, we didn't have to worry about the babysitter messing with the kids. We didn't have to worry about the teachers messing with the kids. We didn't have to worry about being 12 years old, taking a gun to school, shooting and killing somebody. But we didn't have a crazy video game. You know what I think? I think technology is good.
Yeah.
But I think if we just threw away all those smartphones and smart tablets, I think we'll be okay. They don't know how to play hide and go seek no more.
Come on.
Red light, green light, 1, 2, 3. They don't know how to play duck, goose. They don't know no. They don't even know nursery rhyme. They just know whatever the computer say. Children, can I get a witness? And God forbid they run one time around the house, they out of world. They don't even have puberty. Because it's making our minds.
That's right.
They smarter though. I remember, and I ain't gonna call no name, I had to learn how to play this basketball game because of a person named Minister Jeremiah Payne. And I did it because I called myself Bundy. And I did it because, you know, I wanted to spend some time with him. Mm-hmm. But I didn't know the game was rigged up. And every time I played a game, I would lose so bad that I couldn't tell nobody about the game. But even though they're smaller and they are wiser, but how many people know the old people got some wisdom and knowledge?
Yes, sir.
So what did I do? One day I watched him set the game and how he set the features. And I said, oh, okay. So I let him walk out the room. I said, Jeremiah, you want to play? And he said, yeah. So I went in the settings. I set it so I could hit 3 points. I set it so I could slam dunk. I set the game the way he said it. In the middle of the game, he started getting stressed out because the old man was beating the young boy in a game. And he would like scratch his head and he would wonder, how are you doing this? And he said, well, you know what? I don't want to play no more. So I got a visitor from my niece, a little boy named AJ. He thought he was real bad playing basketball. He didn't know that I had been trained up. So he said, I want to play you in some basketball. I said, okay, because I know how to set the games and stuff. But what fascinated me about the game is as I began to play and he saw that he began to lose, he said, hey, you set this game up. So you see how smart our youth are.
Yeah.
They know when the odds are against them.
Yeah.
They know when they're in a good situation and they know when they're in a bad situation.
Yeah.
I'm talking about the fear of the Lord.
Yeah.
Sometimes our kids are politically correct. They know what to say. They know what to do when they're in front of grown folks.
Yeah.
Can I get a couple grown witnesses?
Yeah.
Because think about it for a minute. Look at some of the trouble that they got in that blows your mind. I didn't even know they knew what that was. I didn't even know they know how to say that. Matter of fact, they can teach you.
All right.
Yeah. All right.
Because they got their own little underground teenage language.
Yeah.
Underground.
And see, I had to learn Facebook technology.
Yeah.
I had to learn how to interpret it Twitter.
Yeah.
And I had to learn how to look on YouTube and tell what's good and what's bad. And I had to, there's some more out there, I can't name them, but I asked the kids and see what happened is, I asked them when they didn't think I was paying attention to what they were doing. So even though they're smaller, they have a tendency of telling on each other.
Because
they're like, what is they doing? Oh, this means this. I said, okay, thank you. See, we have to teach them and we have to show them the right way because after all, they're kids.
Amen.
And the thing about it, what God loves, is that God loves obedient children.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something that's fascinating. If you can walk on water like Jesus, that'll be fascinating.
All right.
If you can go cast out evil spirits on the level that Jesus did,
yeah,
I think that'll be okay too.
Yeah.
And God knows if you can turn water into wine,
right,
you'll never be unemployed. Because somebody always wants you to come by and turn their water
into wine.
So what am I saying? Look at all these gifts that Jesus have, and we know that Jesus loved the Father, but there was one thing that Jesus had that was so powerful that a lot of people overlook, and it's called obedience.
Uh-huh.
See, God ain't tell none of us to turn water into wine, but he told us to obey him.
Yeah.
He said, every word that comes out his mouth,
uh-huh,
we should obey.
Yeah.
And if we obey God, my brothers and sisters, a lot of stuff in our lives would be better for us if we would just listen. Your parents know what children are good for you to be around.
Mm-hmm.
Your parents know what time you should go to bed.
Yeah.
Your parents, they know how long you should be studying your school books.
Amen.
After all, you say you want to be somebody, don't you?
Yeah.
But there was never no doctor that became a doctor through a shortcut, and definitely not through a tablet,
right,
and definitely not through a smartphone, and never became a doctor or a lawyer because of your friend. But we want to try to tell y'all why it's early. Have a relationship with God.
Yes,
amen.
Yes.
Amen. Amen.
How many children pray every night? How many children read a Bible every day? See, you have to have a relationship with God. How many parents say, don't you do what I do,
all right,
but you do what I tell you to do? See, we are living witnesses to our children. They're not going to pray if they don't never see your knees get dusty.
All right.
They're not going to read their Bible if they never see you open up the book. They're not going to testify if they don't know what a testimony is.
Uh-huh. Come on, come on.
They have to see some examples.
Yes,
and when they see some examples, I believe, just me and my spirit, that children be one of the shock sometimes too.
All right.
Because only God knows what goes on in school.
Yeah.
Got bullies in school, and you got all these teachers ain't right in school. I ain't trying to say the children always doing the right thing, but all these teachers are not always right. Some of these teachers got some mean attitudes to call themselves teachers.
Yeah. Yeah.
But if you ain't praying,
all right,
you got to pray.
Yeah.
And this is one thing, children, that a Christian should never be negative. Because you are more than a conqueror.
Uh-huh.
I don't care what test they give you. You can make it long as you put everything in God's hands.
Yeah.
I don't care what obstacle you have. You can do it as long as you got a prayer life with Jesus.
All right.
Now, there's a youth that's in the Bible that I want to talk about today. He's a superhero. They call him Jesus.
All right.
He was about 13 years old when his mom and dad got mad at him. And Jesus said, woman, don't you know I'm about my Father's business? A lot of times the older people, we say about the landmark, about how we was taught in church, how we sung in church, how we did devotional service. We talk about the old church. But in order for the young people to participate in the old church, we can teach them the old ways, but new faces.
Yeah. Yeah.
We can teach them the old ways, but let them sing songs.
Yeah.
Let them do devotional service. Let them testify.
Yeah.
Let them do a Bible study. In other words, use your youth.
Yes,
yeah.
Because the world is using them for everything else.
All right.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
I see two little boys that can barely walk, got football helmets on and shoulder pads, trying to play football like the grown man.
Mm-hmm.
They got TV shows where you got the children trying to be rappers, rapping about bad stuff just like the grown people.
Right.
Well, Christians, I'm challenging you. Let's step our game up for our children.
Yeah.
Let's pray more for our children.
Yeah.
Let's help our children. You should make it a requirement.
Yeah.
Before you can go outside and play, you got to read these three scriptures.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Why do children act the way they act? I said like Bill Clinton said, because I can. Mm-hmm. Because we let them.
Yes.
And the thing about a tree, their old people taught me, if the tree get too tall, if the tree get too strong, if the tree get too big, it's hard to bend. That little baby that was cursing and you thought it was funny won't be cursing if we would have just tried to prune that tree up.
Right.
Them little children that do those dirty dances went through those dirty dances, and we would just say it no right then and there.
Amen.
Yeah. Children that have bad attitudes wouldn't have bad attitudes if we would have just straightened it out right then and there.
Amen.
If you look at the news, you got children trying to kill their parents to get their wealth. I wish it wasn't true, but it's true.
Yeah.
Because it's what's in the mind. And we have to understand that the devil comes to steal, kill, and divide. And you got to understand something. He's a master at it. The devil's a master of confusion. He's the master at perversion. He's the master at corruption. He's the master of deception.
Yes, sir.
Now, grown people, I know we got to be sick and tired of our children worshiping these idols. Nothing wrong with a tattoo, but you got people that say that they're in the church. You got people that say that they're saved and doing other things, and they are children heroes. There's something wrong with that picture. So we got to change. We must lead by example. Let me ask you a question. If you are filled with the Holy Ghost and you are righteous and you're doing the right thing and you washed in the blood of the Lamb. Matter of fact, your chair might be right next to Jesus' chair. But the children behind closed doors hear you doing stuff that's not right. That hinders their growth. I'll tell you a little story and I'll try to close. There was a phone call. This lady had a bill collector that called. And the little boy answered the phone. And the lady asked the little boy, who was it? And the bill collector started saying what he was calling for. And long story short, the lady told the little boy, tell the bill collector, I'm not home. You see, you reap what you sow. This little boy got a bad report in school. And the teacher called the little boy home to talk to the parent. But the mother answered the phone. And when the mother answered the phone, the teacher started telling on the student about everything that the little boy was doing wrong. And the little boy asked his mom, well, who is it? He said, it was your teacher. The little boy said, tell them there ain't nobody home. You see, we lead by example. How we want our children to be is how we should be.
Yeah.
We say we love everybody. Well, God is going to make us prove that we don't have political love. God is going to make us prove that we don't have in church at 11 o'clock service love.
All right.
But God is going to make us prove that we have the agape love.
Amen.
And matter of fact, God even made his only son, Jesus Christ, prove that he had some agape love.
Yeah.
When he was in the garden and he started praying, you know, Jesus, he loved us, but he said, do I have to die for them? Is there another way, Father, that I could do it? But Jesus said, nevertheless, not my will, but your will be done. That's what grown people and children should be saying, nevertheless, not my will, but your will should be done. And Jesus, because he loved us, they say they marched him from judgment hall to judgment hall. Now think about you, when somebody say you did something you didn't do, that's a fight.
Right.
But Jesus never said, among the world.
Yes, sir.
Jesus understood his mission. And matter of fact, since we're talking to youth, they was trying to take Jesus out even when he was a baby in a manger. Even when the three wise men came to try to seek him out, they was trying to take Jesus out for a long time. And don't think our children that's born in Christ that the devil ain't trying to take them out.
Amen.
Jesus, he was obedient unto death. I want to tell you something. You sometimes you got to look bad before you can look good.
Amen.
Sometimes you have to learn how to fall in order to stand up firm.
Yeah.
And when you do that, then you will be okay because you will make God happy.
Yeah.
Now I'm talking to the youth. How many youth out there will want to make God happy?
Yeah. Right.
See, the good thing about God is he don't do like what we do. He don't count all your faults. He loves you no matter what. Mm-hmm. And he want to see you prosper. God wants to see every child here be somebody.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
I don't know how they came up with no child left behind, but that was in the Bible a long time ago.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Because Jesus said, for God so loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever shall believe in him shall have everlasting life and shall never perish.
Mm-hmm.
So how many people out there that missed the mark, you ain't got to raise your hand, did some stuff that wasn't right, but you're here today, and God woke you up another morning.
Yeah.
And you know what the real problem is? The real problem is not what you did wrong. Youth, I'm telling you, you got one more grace card. It's not your fault. Because you have to be taught how to resist temptation.
All right.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Somebody said, well, I need more evidence. 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 13 said, there's no temptation that wasn't coming into man. And God will not let you be tempted no more than you can bear. Y'all know how to escape? He said he'll give you a way to escape.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Stay away from bad kids.
Amen.
Stay away from the wrong crowd.
Amen.
Stay away from kids that drink and smoke.
Amen.
Stay away from kids that gang bang.
Amen.
Stay away from the kids that causing trouble.
Amen.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I'm talking about the fear of the Lord.
The Lord.
Yeah.
And children, I speak into y'all spirit because I love y'all.
Yeah.
Because now we keep talking about love and how we supposed to love the children. Now, I charge the children, and I charge the adults right now. See, there's one thing, and I sit down. Children don't talk to us because when they come to us and tell us what they did, some of us go off the handle talking about, what? What you talking about? Kids don't want to hear that. What if Jesus did you like that? Well, Lord, I missed the mark. And Jesus said, what?
Yeah.
You wouldn't even be talking to Jesus. So the point of it is, we have to be understanding for our kids.
Yeah.
It says there's no temptation that wasn't coming to man. So whatever they did wrong is nothing new. Ecclesiastes said there's nothing new under the sun. And be honest now, the truth be told, our children might be nice compared to some of the lives that we had before we got saved.
Amen.
Because one of our singers said, love will make you do right,
mm-hmm.
and love will make you do wrong.
Mm-hmm.
So we must guide our children, nourish our children, teach our children, help our children, pray for our children, and let them know no matter what, everything is going to be all right.
Amen.
I'm going to say this and sit down. If we let them continue to be off the chain, if we say, boy, this youth is out of control, I got news for you. There's going to be some out of control, out of sight people taking care of a bunch of old people that don't have no choice. So we better invest right now.
Amen.
Grown people say amen.
Amen.
Children say amen.
Amen.
Thank you.